My name is Brett Reid. I am the president of Market Unit North America for Weinig and Holzer. So I've been at Weinig and Holzer worldwide since 2017, January. I started by running the Canadian division. So I grew up around the Toronto area. I was hired to run Canada for Weinig and Holzer and moved to just outside Montreal. So that was the first week of January 2017. The first week there was full, let's put it that way. I met a new team, I met my new boss who flew over from Germany, and then I spent a few days there, and then I got on a plane and flew over to Germany for the next 3 weeks. So that was my initiation into the Weinig Holzer group. My first week down in the United States running Market Unit North America was August of 2019. And it was again a very interesting week. Met a lot of new people, went from Canada where we had 15 people to the US where we have 150. So a bit of a change, but I knew a lot of the people here already. So from that standpoint, it was good. I had some relationships with some colleagues here, so it made the transition a little bit easier. But it was busy, let's put it that way. Both times when I started with the company, they were very busy and full of very full weeks. So a day in the life of president of Market Unit North America is full. I get up, I'm usually at the office somewhere between 7 and 7:30. I check emails from Germany. They're up a lot earlier than we are, obviously, so I respond to those. I talk to the finance team to see where we are there. I talk to Andy Turner, our VP of sales, who you've probably met, and talk about what's going on from the sales standpoint. I walk through the company. I usually walk through the building and say hi to most everyone in the building just to see how everybody's doing. And just respond to emails, answer calls from customers, do a bit of travel planning because not only am I here, but I get out to see our customers a lot as well. So it's just a busy full day, and then I usually out of here somewhere around 6 o'clock and get to go home and spend the night and start it all over the next day. When I come to work, I'm excited for a number of reasons. I'm excited for the people that I work with. I'm excited for the challenge of the day and the week and the month and the year. I'm also excited for the various things that I get to touch and do within the company. Running the company, I get to talk to our sales team, our technicians, our finance department, our parts and service people. So it's fun and it's interesting, and I like the challenge of coming to work and touching all the different parts of the company. The biggest surprise moving to the United States, well, the biggest surprise probably was how similar it is and yet how different it is. You think you're in North America and growing up in Canada, buying a house, buying a car, it's very standard, but down here it's all just different. The language is a little bit different as well. There's a lot of y'alls, and we go into some parts of the South and you have to pause and try and pick up on the accents that are there. But for the most part, it's similar but different. That's probably the biggest change. It's the similarity but the differences as well. So the things I miss most about Canada are probably our two daughters. No, not probably, for sure our two daughters. We've got two adult children living in Canada, working and going to school. So, we do miss seeing them. COVID hasn't helped because we haven't been able to go back and forth, but we miss the daughters. And we also miss some of the food items that we would get in Canada. And I don't mean just poutine, which is a staple in Quebec, which is French fries with cheese curds and gravy. I know it sounds horrible, but it's fantastic. And then there's some other things, some condiments and things like that that we don't get down here. But for the most part, I don't miss the weather in Canada. The weather down here is much more conducive to the lifestyle that we like, being outside, being on the water, and just enjoying the outdoors.